Diamond Daryl is sponsored by Randall Amplifiers, and today only we've got Randall Amps 40% off, so if you guys want to take advantage of that. We'd like you to put your hands together and give a big Arlington welcome, because he is a home. Just kidding. What's happening, man? I'm Don Bag from your boys Pantera. There's your man right there. Did you cut it off? Yeah, man, I'm here on the behalf of Randall Amps. Of course, I play Randall's, I think they're the heaviest amps. Pretty chunky. Damn heavy. So I'm gonna open up. I wanna thank my guitar tech, Grady. Grady, see you, champion. I thank Vinny and Rex for jamming on my little DAT tape. Came out in my 8-track room and just cranked it up a little. We got Bobby over here on the camera. If you need any questions or anything out of your car, he'll run out there and get it for you. Where's my mom? My mom's in here tonight. There's mom. Be sure and strap her up double good. There's Belle, Buddy Magazine. And of course, Jam Music. 40% off on Randall's. Gotta tighten that up. We've got some questions, man. Let's do a couple questions. I'll do a little jamming. Question, jam, C cut, and do some autos. Right there.
What do you run through besides Randall?
Good question. I got a Furman PQ4 over here. A little parametric, crank up some stuff, drop some mids, you know, just tighten it up a little. Six band. Badass pickup, Bill Lawrence. Question. Come on. Don't lame it.
How'd you get your beard red?
There you go, bust out, dude. Strings, 9 on the small end, 46 on the big end. Red beard, just cranked it up. Tighten it up a little bit, put some color in it. Oh, yeah, that's my boy over there. This guy's giving a purple Cadillac away coming up, man. Next Tuesday, gold, purple. What did I say, purple? Jeez, I own a purple. Gold Cadillac and small car company. So everybody come on out there, we're gonna be cooking dogs, we're gonna be drinking some beers and doing some illegal shit. Just kidding. We got the fuzz in here tonight, just wanna light him up a little bit. There he is. He's cool.
Where do you think I'm headed?
All right. Cool, questions, guitar questions, anything questions? Somebody? Nobody?
How long have you been playing?
About 13.
13 days.
Anybody, man?
What did you use to develop your alternate picking techniques?
I didn't use anything for it. It just came like, you know, from jamming, yeah. I don't do a lot of just solid downs, you know, like Cowboys from Hell, you know. I see people play and they'll go. You know, I seem to get a little more scratch out of the pick. You go down and bring it up. New level. Cool. Anybody? Everybody's all mellow and low key and burned out and skitzed.
So when you're playing, you don't rest your hand on the bridge or anything. Free.
It's kind of like on that screw, okay, a little bit more on the pickup.
On your palm. Or?
Yeah, you know if you're off, it tools you off, you know. So. So whenever I get ready to jam live, that's usually about 10 minutes before time to get on stage. Of course, crank up a couple shots, a couple brews, start moving, listen to some good music. But for guitar chops, I work with number one and two right here, and I just do trills up and down the neck until I can't, you know, like, I'm sitting there going, nothing's coming out, but, you know, I'm not, like, trying to play something good. I'm just trying to get warmed up, so I start off one and two. Keep on going until it's like, you know, nothing's coming out, but you just got to strain it one time, get the blood flowing. Go to number two, double hell. Then, of course, number three. Yeah. for the right hand. Same thing, just do some picking. Not anything cool, just anything to get moving. So, isn't that something? Boom, Malika. Questions? Anyone? Anyone? Mom? Good question, dude. Deans, they've been out of business for about, 7 years or something like that. And they're back in business. I'm their only endorsee, and they're making this model. They made me one, and it's pretty choice. Got to tighten up a couple things, but they should be on the market here in about 1 or 2 months. Check that door out. Kick it in. Something. How about that shit? All right, man. I guess I'm going to jam. Everybody's needing a little bit of a charge. What's up, Papa?
Hey, you got the same action going from your first fret to the top of the fretboard? Is it the same all the way?
Good question, man. Kind of bring it up a little higher on the big strings. You know, get a little more chunk out of it. A little lower so you can play, you know. Jesus. It's a fucking jam, man.
Work it.
You know it's true. I'm gonna go get some more. Questions.
Can we drink this? Shit.
The bear's smelling good.
Ah, dude, it's stolen. Questions on anything you just checked out? Come on. This is your chance, dude. Bust my shit, man. Let me know what's up.
Two-string bend, man. Did you get with one finger?
Two strings? Like what, dude?
Yeah, when you're bending up. Like a double stop since you're doing it with your... And you're bending up with one finger, holding both fingers. And you do that a lot?
Sure. I mean...
Why not?
Cool. We'll change guitars while you guys rack your brains and pick up some questions. What's the deal?
How often do you use it?
New level, walk. Just, you know, we don't like stick to it all the time, but just to get a little more, you know.
So you usually have like one guitar and the drop D tuning and the other one just...
Yeah.
Okay.
You got sticks, dude?
They're all over your head.
Cool. Hugs. Somebody busted up. It's my man, Scott. You want me to open that one up, huh?
No.
That's cool. This is a guy that calls me up with his guitar in his hand, playing his ass off. This guy's killer, man. Scott, he calls me up, and he's always trying to bust my shit and figure out what I'm jamming through. I always got to keep him cut just a little bit. Just add a little bottom in, dropping some mid, and tightening up some top.
That's the one on the bottom there, the rack effect on the bottom.
Also got a flanger doubler.
Yeah.
And Gray, like, if I hit a squeal or something, you might crank on it a bit.
So he's pretty much working back there when you're working, doing flipping
stuff. Yeah, man, we work together real well.
That's cool.
Hell yeah.
Makes a lot easier to have him do it all yourself.
Yeah, man, you know, I ain't into fucking... you know, that's cool, but I'm too into...
Oh, you concentrate more on what you're doing.
You gotta stomp on his feet when he misses it, man.
Nah, throw a beer at him or something. So, small car company on Tuesday. Cooking dogs, free beer. Cool. Giving a gold Cadillac away. Questions? Somebody? What's up?
Is that the guitar that you had to put back together?
About 8 times, man. Check it out. Looks good, don't it? Took the headstock out. Plenty of stories on that. Jammed on it many a nights, man. Get to the gig, wake up about 10 minutes before time to get on. Grady's in my bunk going, dude, I was carrying the case in, man. And I was just hearing something rattling in there, and I opened it up, dude, your headstock's flopping around in there. Some fucking super glue and a C-clamp. Played it with a C-clamp many a nights, just barely holding it on.
Sure.
Fuck it.
Which bunch up?
Nah, this I won this one, man. And I sold it. I won it in a guitar contest about 8 years ago, and that's how I got turned on to Randall. I won a half stack. Uh-huh. Heard the crunch and said, cool. You know, I could work off of it and try to get something original sounding. You know.
Man, did you use those when you played over at Metalwork way back in
the day? Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Used Randall for a long time.
So who else have you jammed with besides your band?
You name it, man. You know?
You were just at the Randy Rhoads benefit here not too long ago.
Right.
In California.
Uh-huh.
I bet that was pretty cool.
I'll tell you exactly how it was. It was okay, but it was basically a lot of people that were jamming in a cool band at one time that, you know, hadn't been jamming in a long time, that were more skitzed out on their spot or what they're going to jam on, and just everybody running around with their guitar just all just dying to get on stage and jam. I was like, call me when it's my turn, I'll be out in the van, you know. L.A. skid sesh, everybody just, oh, dude, you know. That's how it was, but it was cool. I enjoyed it. We jammed with Blue Saraceno, which is a good bud of mine and, like, one of my new favorites. Turned me on to him. What was that? Wait, lost it. Wrong tuning. Is that watch over there? That's the man that stole a bus driver's watch, and now his name's Watch. Check him out. No, it's true. There it was. Questions?
influence you to pick up the guitar?
Ace Frehley.
That's what I thought.
Ace Frehley, big time.
I read that in a couple of magazine articles. I just wondered how true they were, like, you know, guitar, world guitar practicing musicians. And you said that Ace was God and that he's the one who started and everything like that.
You got it.
And stuff.
Kiss, you know, Kiss, big time. Van Halen.
Yeah.
Shit like that, early Van Halen.
What are some of your favorite Kiss tunes?
What's that?
What are some of your favorite Kiss tunes?
Kiss dudes?
Kiss tunes.
Tunes. Jeez. Every record up Tool. Excuse me. Yeah, Lick It Up or something like that, you know. I even like Lick It Up a little, but, you know, I'm like a big Ace fan, so I'm thinking old Kiss.
What's your favorite band's name, man?
Don't have too many, man. Still listen to my old records a lot, you know.
What about Smog?
Bill Lawrence, XL500Ls. And you know the nickname for him. That's cut, man. Anybody.
Daryl, can you still get those?
Okay. Yeah, man, I get mine from Stuart McDonald.
Really?
Yeah.
OBL's out of business.
I don't know, man. They still got them. I still get them all the time. They're kind of tough to find, man, but the new Dean will have the pickup and everything. Just the full blown. Heavy.
How much?
Huh? How much for the guitar? This one? Priceless. When they come out, I don't know. So it's kind of like we're still working that out. They're going to have like the full blown series. And then they're gonna have like the half C cut series, which is gonna be like, you know, cheaper, probably bolt on neck and some shit like that.
Is that like a Les Paul scale length or more of a Strat?
Les Paul. Definitely Les Paul family. Is Jerry Warden in the house? Okay. I guess we're gonna do a little more jamming. Anybody?
What about lessons?
Yeah.
You ever take any lessons
to
teach yourself?
It's pretty much just sit in my room and jam when I used to have time to. Check it out. Wawa, kids. Questions.
Is that an older Wawa or a newer box?
It's a new one. It's one in box. Seems like it's got more range. What's up here?
That sucked. Except he does it without that fucking pedal, yeah. You know?
Have you ever got a chance to meet him or anything? Talk to him?
Nah, I heard he's into it, though. Right. I heard he's got a singer and made him skin his head back a little.
Hey, man, when you play live, like you were just doing, like a tune that has a rhythm background like that, what do you do? You just do it like that? Or
just let Rex handle it, you know? No problem. Just like, same thing like Van Halen, old Van Halen.
Yeah,
right.
Fuck you. Bless you.
Where do your lead extensions come from? I mean, besides just practicing.
My what now?
Your lead extensions. Like, do you go out of pentatonic? Do you usually run like?
Dude, you know, I do some pentatonic, little minor, little major. You know, that's about as far as it goes. I'm not like, you know. You know, scale god or nothing. You know, I'm not into that, sitting around looking at a book. Just kind of just go for it. A lot of the stuff I do is just like key of A, G, wherever, just like straight down. I hear that thing again? Nice little candy sway going. What do you think of that? It's good, don't it?
Face mouth.
Face mouth. The bitch got a face mouth.
That sucks.
That's cool. This chick came over to my house and strapped me in. I was like, didn't know who she was, and she was just hanging out and kept hanging out, wanted to know a little bit about the clock, about the carpet, what's up with the dog, why, you know, about Richard up the street. Just kept going and kept going. I'm like, every time I go and say something, she's, oh, yeah, you know what, you know, kept going. And she breaks out this pipe, dude. This dead serious, man, about a month ago. Breaks out this fucking crank pipe, dude. Starts loading it up, and she's going to fire it up right there in my house, you know. Couldn't get a word in. That lasted about 2 hours. Of course, she got kicked with the pipe, went down. But, wrote a tune about her. She's the kind of girl that thinks she's smart because she's on crack. She tells it through her glass pipe, the very thing she sees the world through. First base, second base, third base, home run. Had a crank girl up on a tune. Light her up a tad. What's that? No.
Come on, man.
Four track. New record. We're taking some time right now. As soon as we can get it rolling, you know, we're going to go out and do 6 dates with Megadeth, which was supposed to be 2 months, but I guess Dave had to go to rehab and tighten himself up again. So I'm serious. And so they're all straight again. And so they went out with another straight band, Aerosmith. So they're going to do like the Evian tour, Water or something. I'll be burning some rope and shooting 7 as usual till I blow a kidney muscle or something. Cool. You know, it's true. Dude, check this out, man. I weigh 170.
Yeah!
Dude, seriously, been home for like a month and I'm all toughed up and shit. You know, it's true. You guys want to crank up on something? You got questions. Let's do a last round of questions before I crank on my last piece. Then everything C-section. You want to know how to do some squeals? Or do you want to learn some Steve Vai?
That's good.
How come, what's the green tape? Is that so you can see in the dark, basically? Or?
Yeah.
So when you start stage, you can see where.
All buzzed up, looking for it.
Yeah. That's what I figured.
You know. So, man, Squeals, check it out. Let me teach you a little lesson here, since I'm the teacher of the evening. Squeals, dude, just tighten up the top big strings. Let your thumb with the cane nail hanging over it. Quieten it up a little. Cut the little ones down. Just leave the G open. Flick it. Look, Mom, no hands. So you flick the G, right, Dad? Drop the bar. And while it's down, get you a harmonic. You know what I'm saying? But you do it pretty quick, you know, you don't really hear the bam, you know, it just goes one time. Catch it? Small lesson.
When you pull those like off the second fret, is that can that be tricky, or is there anything that may need to be adjusted on the bridge?
Nah, okay. Not really. It's just like, just go for it, you know. Everybody's like harmonics, huh? Fifth, seventh, 12th, you know. That's like natural harmonics and shit. But as far as I'm concerned, there's pretty much a harmonic everywhere. Like on the front for like heresy.
Does it kind of help to use like the try to pick up and a lot of gain, as much gain as you get?
Yeah. Sure, you know, I mean, the more gain, the more it's going to be open to catch a harmonic, and of course, the more treble. But you don't want to get it all shrill and stuff, you know? Demons, I do these down here. Catching something?
Yeah.
How many years have you been playing?
About 13. Or 13. I don't know, Mike, how long have you been selling cars? 4. Huh? Skids, look. That's your boy right there. If you need a car, he'll tuck the note for you. Tuck the note, dude. It's cool. Getting ready to rock it up one last time. Questions, man, if you got it. Bust me up, dude.
Who writes most of the songs?
I write most all the riffs, and Phil writes most all the lyrics, but it's between me, Vinny, and Rex. You know, that's where it all comes together and stuff. Everybody's got, like, you know, some ideas and stuff. I got, like, the main parts of the riffs and stuff, and we just get together and,
you know. Somebody tries to change your riff? Like, why don't you try something else?
We try it. We try
it.
Wide open. Nobody, yeah, we don't skid.
So nobody really argues that much or whines, like, no, I want it this way.
Nah, we don't have, like, that setup where if you're the one that writes the song, you make all the money, you know, we got it cut up cool.
Oh, well, absolutely.
You know, so.
But as far as writing the song, really making the song, like.
Well, that's why they're as powerful as they are, is because all four of us, you know, go back and forth, and we always agree, you know.
Agree.
When it comes down, you know, we'll try anything until it's right. But or what we think's right.
Yeah, you never feel dissatisfied with a song.
No. Like, especially not Vulgar Display of Power.
Like
it's only getting better. What?
Like writing it one way and then somebody else, well, let's try it another way.
Nah. If you can better it, man, go for it, you know, of course.
But say you liked it the other way.
Well, dude, get roped up and figure it out, you know?
Well, that's what we're having, because we got that white bass player. No, it's got to be like this.
Well,
like
fuck it. Put a beard on his neck and tell him to gel. Check it out. Just listen, man.
Hey,
fuck.
It don't work, man.
Well, she called the cops. I don't know. Fuck.
Come on, say new bass player. Right.
Yeah, whatever.
You know how to play is heavy metal stuff. You grew
First song too. I swear it was. Bell was on bass back then. Bell was on bass. not the free bass though, like that chick though. That's the chick, dude. She's famous and she don't even know it. Questions? Man, as Pantera, a while. You know, because we're doing this new record. We're going to do these 6 dates with Megadeth, come back and just crank it out. So as soon as the new record gets done, dude, you know we're going back out on tour. We tour our asses off. You know, we've been out for fucking two and a half years almost. If you count Cowboys from Hell, you know, it's been solid for 3 or 4, you know. Been on the Billboard charts for 68 weeks straight now. Still hadn't dropped out of the top 200. Got a gold record, which is I'm real proud of. We're all real proud of. You know, it's 500,000 copies sold. It's up to 600,000 now. Cowboys is at 425, about to be 500, which is going to be gold. You know, so just keep selling. Keep selling, and the faith's there, and the fans are there, and everything's good, and looking forward to getting back out and doing it again. And that's why everything that's gone so good for us, we're not going to fuck up by, you know, trying to write a good record or anything that's going to make us any more money, because everything that's ever made is in the first place was you, the fans, and enjoying what we do, the heavy stuff. So the next record's just gonna be a serious, solid. So you look for that. You know, when I was a kid and I wanted to buy a heavy record, I went and bought Metallica records, you know, or anything like that, you know, Judas Priest. And I was always let down if I took the record home and it didn't crush me, you know, and then you start looking for somebody else to do it. You know, now we're the guys that a lot of kids are going out to buy the records to get pulverized, you know, and so it's what we do best, so why fucking change it?
You play live, man. Do you improvise live or do you just play straight?
Well, I kind of play what's on the records a lot live, you know, and it's like, you know, people that don't play guitar, if you like improvise and just go off on something, yeah, they think you fucked up, you know, they don't like hear it for like something else. Yeah. So kind of pretty much stick to the stuff on the record.
Do you sit down and write the stuff, write your solos out before you play them on the record, or do you like improvise on the record then?
A little of both, you know. Solos like Walk and stuff like that were like the first things I played when we were writing the song. You know, we were going to the lead section. I look at Rex and go, hey, you know, and I just fake it and switch keys. I was bored and I went, pulled that number, you know. So stuff like that stays, but I also take it home to my 8-track sometimes and, you know, just sit there and play a couple tracks on that and then just pick the best of that. It's never really been a problem to sit there and try to figure out, you know, what's this one gonna take, you know? But, you know, sometimes you gotta fuck with it, so.
What's the live?
Are all the songs in for the next release?
No. No, it's like Vulgar Display. We wrote Vulgar in like almost 2 weeks, had it cut in 2 months. You know, I hear all these bands taking, you know, years and shit to do their records, and, you know, we do it like live anyway, so it doesn't take that long.
I was going to ask, what was, you know, when you jammed with Rob Halford, didn't y'all do something with Rob Halford on a record or something like that? And, you know, was he pretty cool? Or was he?
Yeah, Rob's great. He's a huge Pantera fan. He called us up to back him up. He's doing Fight right now, which is his new band. And we just did that one track for him, Light Comes Out of Black, for Buffy the Vampire Slayer, whatever it was. Pretty cool. Lots of fun. We did that song one day, and he sang it the next day, and you got mixed and it's done. You know? Anybody else? Last call for alcohol. What's up, Pops?
How many hours a day you practice?
Shit. Okay. Actually, I hadn't played since I got home from the last clinic run. Just did 6 dates. Almost got killed on a fucking prop plane. Fucking skidding my ass off. Got home, just, you know, I don't really have time to practice, you know. If I'm gonna be playing, I'm gonna be writing bass mouth or something, just having fun, you know. True to life experience.
Doing a lot for other bands too.
What's that? Sure, sure. I mean, if you got a demo tape and you're jamming, you know, I'll help you out or tighten you up. Cool. Sure. I mean, you know, I'm into Texas bands and stuff. You know, my fucking word is go, you know, do it up. When I'm in town, you know, of course, if somebody's jamming up the street, Lonesome Dove or whatever, you know, Bell calls me up, dude, what's going on, Lonesome Dove, dude? You know, go tighten it up, get up on stage, jam a couple tunes, whatever, no problem. Any questions about my column in Guitar World?
How long will it last?
I ask them that too, you know. I said, fuck, I'm running out of shit, man, you know. Now they said, you know, as long as they keep getting good, you know, fan mail on it and shit, and they said, like, you know, like, my column's getting, like, really good, you know, reports and shit, and people writing in some good shit and stuff, and they said, you know, they keep tightening me up on it, so crank up on some symmetrical. So you ready to rip it one time?
Let's do it up. Crank this one up real good. Let's do it one last time. Light up the Chinese restaurant.
Turn! Fucker! Randall and Jam Music and you for coming and showing up. Be sitting over here pulling some autographs off here in about 2 minutes.
Cool.
Fucking
possible, you know. We just got to get that new record done, you know. We'll be on tour, and of course we want to come back to hometown, you know.
Have you ever jammed with anybody? Like, get blessed
or
stuff?
Jam always, man. It may happen, man. I don't make appointments or nothing, you know.
I know.
Sure, man, but fuck, you know. It's never a free for all going off at a club or something, dude. You know it. Of course, my favorite too. Hey, yo. Okay, man. Keep jamming, bro.
Yeah, keep jamming too.
Oh, you know it. Thanks, bro. Appreciate it. How much? How you doing, man?
John?
You're going to Pasco High School, right? You're going to Pasco High School?
No, man.
Yeah.
Sure didn't, bro. Went to Bowie and a little bit of Arlington.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Fucking school. I'm out of there, man. You know, I was like, going to be a half a credit short to graduate, so I just like canceled and
failed.
Should have paid a little more attention, but hell. Yeah, it's doing all right, man. Be cool, man.
Thanks.
Keep ripping, bro. There you go. Yeah, tighten yourself up, bud. There you go. How you spell it so I don't tool it?
M-I-G-U-E-L.
San Miguel, you ever heard of it? Beer?
San Miguel, yeah.
Yeah? All over it, huh?
So which boy is there right now?
Probably out having fun somewhere.
Yeah. Yeah. Stay heavy, man.
Oh, man. Ain't no question, too, right. Bud. Miguel, yeah, take care.
All right. See you.
Right on, man. Mike. Parametric's got knobs, right? It's kind of new. No?
It's kind of old.
They don't make them. It sounded better on the ground.
It's the old boss.
Did you ever get a blue EQ and try that? They're real hard to come by. They make them now. I don't know if they're anywhere near like
Jim Dunlop.
Yeah, Jim Dunlop. I don't know if it's the same thing at all.
Yeah, I found one of those Furman EQ3s. The older one that
you got. Is it green?
Yeah,
red knobs?
It's got red.
Good one, man. That's the first one I ever got.
I think that's the one you had when I went down there. I remember it being red.
Went down where?
Over to the studio.
Wasn't for Cowboys from Hell, though, was it?
No. It was the actual one.
Huh?
A little bit of it.
cool.
Yeah, it sounds great through like headphones or through good PA system.
Need one for my fucking 4-track, 8-track. How much does the shit run?
It's like $26.50 retail.
The whole thing?
Yeah. Dude, it's chugging. It's got like 500 different sounds.
Damn.
Yeah. You're built in sequence too, so you could like program like background bongo parts or conga drums.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Dude, like, it's got bass lines too.
Fuck, I never read the manual long enough to learn how to do all the cool shit, man.
Well, that's
I just want to turn it on and get on it.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know it. Get you some, dude.
Will this thing run off triggers? Could you buy just this?
Well, it's all priced as a package, but you can, you know, you can set up any kind of trigger.
You can?
Sure.
Yeah. How much would that?
The module itself retails for $750.
Curious,
well, yeah, Dan's trying to turn it up. Yeah, Dan, when you turned it up,